अस्सलाम वालेकुम बॉयज़ एंड गर्ल्स, वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल लेट्स जॉइन फार्मेसी। सो टुडे आई एम हियर टू डिस्कस अबाउट दैट इज डी नोवा बायोसिंथेसाइज ऑफ फैटी एसिड। माय डियर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन। व्हाई आई एम सेइंग मीन्स हियर इन बायोकेमिस्ट्री इन द ईयर 2020 दिस क्वेश्चन वॉज आस्क्ड। सी यू ऑब्जर्व द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, एक्सप्लेन द डी नोवा बायोसिंथेसाइज ऑफ फैटी एसिड अलॉन्ग विद द एंजाइम सिस्टम इन्वॉल्व एंड इट वॉज ऑल्सो आस्क्ड इन द ईयर 2018 सी ईयर। Explain the de novo biosynthesis of fatty acid along with the enzyme system involved. So there will be greater chance to ask in the year 2021. Okay, so my request to all to observe the video at last. Clear, my dear brothers and sisters? If you belongs to any university, means if you are studying in B pharmacy or any other subject, if that biosynthesis or synthesis of fatty acid is present in your concept, in your syllabus, means 110% this question is a fix for your examination. Yes, so let's start. My dear brothers and sisters, see here. First, we will study about biosynthesis of fatty acid. Now, here for the first one, biosynthesis of fatty acid. De novo means newly synthesized of fatty acid that occurs predominantly in liver, kidney, adipose tissue, lactating mammary gland. Mainly, my dear brothers and sisters, these synthesize of fatty acid, mainly it occurs in the liver, kidney, adipose tissue or in the lactating mammary gland. Clear? Then the enzyme machinery for the this fatty acid production is located in the cytosol of the cell. Okay, you know that any metabolism in the human body begins in the either it in the cytosol of the cell membrane or in the mitochondria. So here mainly the biosynthesis of fatty acid, the whole enzymes, 7 to 8 enzymes are present where? In the cytosol of the cell. Then acetyl coenzyme A is the source of carbon atom, while NADPH and ATP supplies energy for ATP formation. Here a simple meaning, acetyl coenzyme A, it is the initial source for the synthesis of this fatty acid. Which one is that? Acetyl coenzyme A. Here after we will study where in the preparation of this chart, fatty acids here, acetyl coenzyme A, it is the first source and it is very easy chart, very easy schematic representation. For looking it is difficult, but if you practice means in 5 to 10 minutes, approximately 15 minutes you can cover this. Why I am saying acetyl CoA? Because it is the source, first initial source for synthesis of fatty acid. Then here what happens, NADPH and ATP, these are energy suppliers. Okay, energy supplied by means of these two coenzymes. Yes. Then the synthesis of fatty acid divided into two steps. How the fatty acid get ready or synthesized means by two steps. First is a conversion of acetyl coenzyme A to malonyl coenzyme A. Okay, the first step, it is what we are doing in the first step, just acetyl CoA get converted to the malonyl coenzyme A. Clear? Then the second step, reaction of fatty acid synthetase complex. Here in the second step, what happens? All the fatty acid synthetase complex shows their reactions. Okay, how, why? Because to prepare these fatty acid. And second step is very important, very very important step. Okay, yes, let's study. See here, my dear brothers and sisters, the first step, that is conversion of acetyl coenzyme A to malonyl coenzyme A. Here what happened? Acetyl coenzyme A is carboxylated to malonyl coenzyme A by the enzyme acetyl coenzyme carboxylase. Here carboxylated means what? Just transfer of a carbon dioxide. Okay, why? To form this malonyl coenzyme A. Okay, understand the point. Acetyl coenzyme A, this one is carboxylated, means it produces the carbon dioxide to form this, which one? That is a malonyl coenzyme A. Okay, by the help of the enzyme acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase. You can write in this way also, acetyl coenzyme A, it is the enzyme, okay, which helps to convert the acetyl coenzyme A into malonyl coenzyme A. Easy you can write. And this is an ATP dependent reaction, okay, and requires a biotin for the carbon dioxide fixation. Clear, my dear brothers and sisters? Here one point is very peculiar. Why? Means biotin, you are observing here biotin. Okay, biotin is very essential because to fix the carbon dioxide, to fix the carbon dioxide or to initiate the process of a carboxylation. Carboxylation. So here biotin is very important with the and also with the addition of this ATPs. Okay, it is the ATP dependent. Which one? That is conversion of acetyl coenzyme A to melonyl coenzyme A. This is our first step. First step is completed. Now let's move towards the next step. Here you are observing the next step is reactions of a fatty acid synthetase complex. Here simple reactions, okay, don't worry about complex reactions. Here the reactions are very simple. Very simple. In the name itself, it's indicating complex, synthetase complex. But if you practice, means in 5 to 10 minutes, you can cover this whole concept. And you can easily score the marks with a good knowledge. Yes, then reaction of fatty acid synthetase complex. First of all, see here, just we will study some of the initial points. The remaining reactions, means after the conversion of acyl coenzyme A to melonyl coenzyme A, what happened? The remaining reactions of fatty acid synthetase are catalyzed by multifunctional enzyme known as a fatty acid synthetase. Okay, multifunctional enzyme. This multifunctional enzyme is known as a fatty acid synthetase. My dear brothers and sisters, you remember these two points. Okay, fatty acid synthetase, FAS. The two multifunctional enzyme are, that is ACP. ACP, it is the one multifunctional enzyme. Another one is cysteine, CYS. Here ACP means what? Acyl carrier protein. Acyl carrier protein. Okay, here these are the two fatty acid synthetase complex. One is a ACP, that is acyl carrier protein. Another one is a cysteine. You remember these two. If you know these two, means easily you can know this reactions of fatty acid synthetase. Yes. The first what happened here, the remaining reactions occur fatty acid by means of fatty acid synthetase catalyzes by multifunctional enzyme, that is FAS, that is a fatty acid synthetase. The first step means in this step, the sub step, the two carbon fragment of acetyl coenzyme A, very simple, see here, the two carbon fragment of acetyl coenzyme A is transferred to acetyl carrier protein of fatty acid synthetase. This is acetyl coenzyme A, okay. Just the two carbon fragment of this acetyl coenzyme A, it transfers to where it transfers? It transfers to this ACP fatty acid synthetase, okay. ACP fatty acid synthetase, and it was catalyzed by the enzyme, that is acetyl coenzyme A ACP transacylase. What happens? Two fragment carbon of the acetyl coenzyme A is transferred to the, which one is transferred to the, that is a fatty acid synthetase enzyme known as ACP. Okay, ACP. Okay, with the help of the enzyme acetyl coenzyme A, ACP transcarbolase, acylase to form the product. What is that product? That is acetyl SACP. Clear, acetyl SACP is formed. Then the acetyl unit is then transferred from ACP to cysteine, residue of the enzyme. Thus ACP site falls vacant. Simple. Here what happens? What is formed by means of this acetyl coenzyme A? By acetyl coenzyme A, while it combines with this which fatty acid synthetase, with the help of this enzyme, there will be formation of acetyl SACP. Now what happens? This acetyl from the ACP synthetase, what they will do, these will transfer to the cysteine. The acetyl group, the acetyl unit will transfer to the cysteine with the help of the enzyme transfer of acetyl to the cysteine. Clear? How? See here. Same. What happens? This is the acetyl group, they transfer to the cysteine. Cysteine is formed. Cysteine, S, C double bond, CH3. This is the acetyl unit. It transferred to the cysteine. So here ACPSH is remained vacant. Okay, that is a acyl carrier protein remain vacant. At that time, what this acyl carrier protein do? Now see. Until here, is there any doubt? Yes, very good. Here the residue of the, thus ACP site falls vacant, mean it falls empty. Clear? Why? Because of removal of which one? The removal of acetyl unit, acyl unit. Clear? Then the enzyme melonyl coenzyme A ACP transacylase transfers melonate from melonyl coenzyme A to bind to ACP. Simple, very simple. What happens here? The enzyme, which enzyme? That is a melonyl coenzyme ACP transacylase. What it will do? It will transfer the melonate from the melonyl coenzyme A. How this melonyl coenzyme A came? It came by means of the first step, that is conversion of acyl coenzyme A into melonyl coenzyme A. Okay, now because of the vacant, where the vacant in the ACP, so this melonyl coenzyme ACP transacylase enzyme will help to transfer the melonate from melonyl coenzyme to binds with this ACP, so what happens, this product is formed. Okay, this is the acetyl unit with the cysteine. Here what is this? This is the melonyl coenzyme, melonyl unit with the ACP. Here everything is functional, everything is formed now. Yes, this product is known as acyl melonyl enzyme. Clear? Acyl melonyl enzyme. And this is the second reaction. First reaction is this conversion. The second reaction is which one? This is the second reaction to form the acyl melonyl enzyme. Next, in the third reaction, the acetyl unit which was attached to the cysteine is transferred to melonyl group. Here, simple. See here, what is this? This is the melonyl acetyl group attached to the cysteine. This acetyl group attached to the cysteine, it transfers to the melonyl group. Okay, to form that beta ketoacyl ACP. Here, you see the melonyl, and here what happens? By transferring of this acetyl from the cysteine. Okay, see, acetyl get transferred where? To the melonyl group. What happens? There will be loses of carbon dioxide. Why loses of carbon dioxide? Means because initial, where in the conversion of acyl coenzyme A to the melonyl coenzyme A, there will be process of carboxylation. Means carboxylase is we done there. Where? During the conversion of the acyl coenzyme A to the melonyl coenzyme A. Okay, there will be process of known as carboxylase by means of enzyme acetyl coenzyme carboxylase. So this carbon dioxide is removed. Why this carbon dioxide is removed? Means so that's why your fatty acid doesn't contain any type of the carbon dioxide. The fatty acid chain not contains any type of the carbon dioxide. So we have to remove this carbon dioxide. Clear? Thus carbon dioxide is never incorporated into fatty acid carbon chain. Same meaning. Thus beta ketoacyl ACP is formed by beta ketoacyl synthetase, ACP synthetase. See here. After the transfer of the acetyl from the cysteine to the melonyl group, what happens? There will be formation of beta ketoacyl ACP with the help of the enzyme, that is beta ketoacyl ACP synthetase. Clear? This is your product. Here, this is the acetyl unit. It was transferred to the melonyl unit. See, one is a melonyl unit, another one is a acetyl unit. Clear? And here, what happened? Cysteine SH is vacant here, remaining. Understand the topic? Yes. Very simple. Just you have to practice. Now, let's move towards the next page. In next page, what happens? See here, very easy, simple concept. In next step, what happens, my dear brothers and sisters? This beta ketoacyl means ketoacyl group reduces to the hydroxy group with the help of the enzyme that is known as beta ketoacyl ACP reductase. See here, this is the beta ketoacyl ACP. It get reduces with the help of the enzyme beta ketoacyl ACP reductase to form beta hydroxy acyl ACP, and it is the NADPH dependent process. Here what happens? There will be generation of NADPH plus H plus into NAD P plus molecules. So this is the reducing equivalents are supplied by NADPH. Clear? This you understand. Now next, let's study about the fifth reaction. Now this formed beta hydroxy acyl ACP, it again what happens? It converted to the transenoyl ACP. How? Means by means of this beta hydroxy acyl ACP dehydratase. Means removal of water molecule. By removal of water molecule from this beta hydroxy acyl ACP, we form one more unit, one more unit, that is a transenoyl ACP. Let's see here the description. Beta hydroxyacyl ACP undergoes the dehydration, means removal of water. A molecule of water is eliminated and the double bond is introduced between the alpha and beta carbons. Here, removal of water molecules, okay, from this beta hydroxy ACP. After removal, what happens? There will be double bond introduction or the synthesized production of the double bond between alpha and beta. Clear? The side to the functional group, this is the C double bond O functional group, okay. The side to that functional group, that is alpha carbon atom, first carbon is alpha and the second carbon is beta carbon atom. The two double bond are incorporated or in between this alpha and beta carbon. That structure is known as a transenoyl ACP. Clear? The transenoyl ACP is formed by dehydration of beta hydroxyacyl ACP, and this is the fifth reaction. Now let's move towards the sixth reaction. What happens? This enoyl ACP reductase reduces transenoyl ACP to acyl ACP. Okay, just you have to remember the reduction, reduce conversion. What happens? This transenoyl ACP will reduce to the acyl ACP or butyryl ACP with the help of the enzyme enoyl ACP reductase. Okay, it get reduced, and this acyl ACP is also known as butyryl ACP. Butyryl means it is the four carbon atom attached to this which one? Fatty acid synthetase. This is the fatty acid synthetase, the complex. Okay, this complex attaches the which one? That is the four carbon atom. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four carbon atom, one saturated substance that's known as butyryl ACP. Got the point? Now what happens, my dear brothers and sisters? See, this is very important step. It is a NADPH dependent reaction. Here what happens? There will be conversion of NADPH plus H plus into the NADP plus. So it is the NADPH molecule, NADPH dependent process. Now the carbon atom attached to the ACP is transferred to the cysteine residue, and the reactions 2, 6 are repeated 6 more times. Here just very simple statement is this. The carbon chain attached to the ACP, what happens, which the carbon chain is attached to the ACP, is a transfer to cysteine residue. Here this is the carbon chain attached to the ACP. Now this carbon chain, what it will do, this carbon chain which attached to the ACP, it transfer to the cysteine, it get transferred. Here let's see. Simple here, what happens means, means the cysteine residue, okay, means the carbon chain attached to the ACP, that should be transferred to the cysteine residue, and the reaction 2 and 6 repeated 6 more times. Yes, simple. What happens, this is the carbon chain attached to the ACP. This ACP attached with the carbon chain, it should transfer to this cysteine. Okay, by transferring, what happens? The reaction second, this one is the first reaction here, this is the second. The reaction second and the reaction six should be, reaction second reaction should be reacted six times. It should be how many times? That are repeated six more times. Why? Means because to form the fatty acid. Okay. At the end, 7 cycles should be required to synthesize this complete fatty acid. Clear? At the end of the 7 cycle, the fatty acid synthesis is completed. What happens after this acyl? Means the carbon chain attached to this ACP, where it transfer to the cysteine, then there will be formation of product, that is acyl S enzyme. Which one? Acyl S enzyme. See here. Clear? So after this formation, the reaction 2 and second repeated 6 more times to form this which one? That is the cycle, that is fatty acid, to synthesize this fatty acid. Now let's discuss. Thus a 16 carbon fully saturated fatty acid, namely palmitate bond to ACP, is formed. After all the 7 cycle, after all the 2 and 6 reactions repeated for 6 times, what happens? There will be formation of this palmitate. This is the palmitate. And that palmitate is bonded with this palmitate. It is bonded with this FAS, means fatty acid synthesis. The palmitate bonded with this fatty acid synthesis. These get separated. Okay, the two get separated by means of enzyme that is palmitoyl thioesterase. Palmitoyl thioesterase helps to catalyze or helps to break down these or helps to separate palmitate and FAS. Clear? This is the palmitate. CH3CH2CH2 13 CO minus, and this is the FAS, that is fatty acid synthetase. This is the formation of the newly fatty acid. Okay, a 16 carbon newly fatty acid is formed, my dear brothers and sisters. Yes, this is the completion of your fatty acid synthesis. The notes are available in the description. Go to description, check the description. If you are new to this channel, subscribe the channel and share this channel with your friends. Thank you.